The Super Cameo Cond experiment mainly observes neutrinos by using a huge water tank with about 13,000 PMTs. Neutrinos have no electric charge and pass through matter, so it is very difficult to detect them. However, a neutrino occasionally interacts with matter and a charged particle is generated. The 50,000 tons of water as a big target can increase the number of interaction between neutrinos and nucleons or electrons. It is possible to detect the charged particle when the charged particle generated in water has a faster speed than the speed of light in water. The Cherenkov light is emitted. This phenomenon is similar to that the diagonal wave is made on the water surface, when a duck moves at a higher velocity than the speed of the water surface wave. The Cherenkov light is emitted in a cone shape to the direction of a charge particle. The photomultiplier tubes, PMTs, on the wall of the tank detect this Cherenkov light. The PMTs have information about the quantity of the detected light and the timing of the detection. The energy, direction, point of interaction and type of charged particle are determined by the information provided by the PMTs. The primary cosmic ray, mainly protons, is continuously poured on the Earth. When the cosmic ray interacts with the terrestrial atmosphere, muons, electrons and neutrinos, referred to as secondary cosmic rays, are generated. Many muons lose their energy and stop in the ground. In contrast, neutrinos do not stop as they rarely interact with matter. The mountain above the detector acts as an umbrella and protects from cosmic ray muons, which become the background for neutrinos' observation. The 1,000 meters rock overburden reduces the cosmic ray muons to 1/100,000th of the ground surface.